When you play Fortnite, you're going to die a lot. Dying is a part of the game, and a natural process to improve. Listen, each time you die, it's a chance to learn from a mistake you made. And trust me, you're making a lot of mistakes, even if you don't know it yet. In this post, you're going to learn about some of the common Fortnite mistakes players make. As you read through this list, you will understand more about your own mistakes, and what you can do to fix them and become a better Fortnite player as a result. Mistake number 1. Not playing for high ground. The high ground is key to victory in Fortnite. When you have the high ground, you are able to put a lot of pressure on your opponents, especially when you have the ultimate high ground. In other words, when you're above anyone else in the game at that point. Of course, there are some risks when taking the high ground, and I'll explain that later. For now, you should know that when you have height, it's hard for opponents to see and shoot at you, but it's easy for you to see and shoot down at everyone else. The problem, though, is that most people don't know how to get the high ground. Yes, you might know how to build, but what do you do when someone builds over you? If you've come from a different shooter, for example, PUBG, Apex Legends, or Call of Duty, then building and the high ground might seem unnatural to you. The best way to learn how to get the high ground is by jumping into a creative game. You can do that either by yourself or with a friend. I recommend playing against a friend, because when you play with a friend, you can quickly practice build battles against each other. This will help you learn what to do in build battles faster than if you were to play just the standard game modes, since you can get into more fights this way. Now you can practice the common building techniques and high ground retakes until they feel comfortable, and you're confident you can consistently pull them off. Next, start applying what you've learned in a real game against real opponents. You see, it's easy to be a great builder when you play in a low-pressure setting, like creative mode against a friend. But to be an excellent Fortnite player, you need to be able to use what you've learned in a real game. And the only way to do that is to start today. Mistake number 2, jumping too much. Do you lose a lot of 1v1 close quarters fights? Well, it could be because you jump too much, and it's a common mistake new players make. Let me explain why. When you jump, you move in a standard arc. In other words, your movements are predictable, so it's easy to track and hit you. As you know, you don't want your movements to be predictable. You want them to be unpredictable. You can make your movements more unpredictable by making them dynamic. In other words, by mixing strafing left and right with crouching so you're difficult to hit. Also, when you jump, your crosshairs expand. Therefore, your bloom gets worse, and you're more likely to miss your shots. Jumping and shooting are especially difficult if you play with a controller, because you have to take your thumb off the right stick to jump. But you can use the claw grip to hold your controller, so you can jump without losing control of your aim and take full advantage of aim assist. If you're jumping a lot of the times in a fight, then it's time to stop. However, you do want to jump as you run around the map regularly, so you're hard to hit from a distance. You see, you're an easy target to hit if you just run in a straight line, because enemies can easily track you with a sniper rifle or an assault rifle. Just take it easy with the jumping in your next fight, okay? Mistake number 3, building with wood. Wood is the weakest material for building in Fortnite. Here is a chart that shows the health of a wall for each building material over time. As you can see, wood has the lowest starting health and lowest max health, so it has the lowest health at all times. Then why do so many players build with wood? And why are there guides that advise you to build with wood? Listen, the wood used to be the best material to build with because it had the highest starting health, but there have been so many patches and balance updates, and this isn't true anymore. Of course, wood is the easiest material to farm because it's found all over the map. How many trees do you think there are in Fortnite? You should focus some of your time on Fortnite farming for the material, but don't spend all your time farming wood. Instead, consciously look to farm for stone and metal, and use it first when you're in a fight, because your structures will be stronger, so you will be better protected. Mistake number 4, not playing Kovacs. Kovacs FPS Aim Trainer is the most effective way to train and improve your aim in Fortnite, but it's only available to PC players. Sorry, console players. Of course, controller users playing on a PC may play Kovacs, however, that's a minority of the Fortnite player base. Anyway, if you play on a PC with a mouse and keyboard, playing Kovacs is a must. Even playing for just 10 minutes a day can be enough to have tremendous benefits. You see, Kovacs is very useful if you're someone that doesn't have enough time to play several hours a day, but you want to be able to keep up with players that do. Listen, one of the biggest weaknesses Fortnite players have is their aim, because Fortnite has a lot of time where you aren't playing and practicing. Aim trainers are a solution to downtime, and Kovacs is the best aim trainer available right now. Mistake number 5, getting stuck in the storm. A mistake I see some players make is simply not paying attention to the storm. You know, the storm is dangerous, especially as the game progresses, because each tick of the storm does more damage. So why are you getting caught in it? Listen, the map in the top right-hand corner of your screen has a timer, and the timer lets you know when the next zone is going to move. You can also open your map to see where the next circle is and how far you need to travel to get there, so you can plan when you need to move accordingly. Also, you may find it useful to know that the further you're away from the next circle, the faster the storm moves, and the closer you are to the next circle, the slower the storm moves. So if you can get yourself in a good position, you can actually outrun the storm. This can be helpful for getting to the next circle, because you feel confident no enemies are following behind you. Mistake number 6, using a sensitivity that's too high. Using a sensitivity that's too high is a mistake players make when playing shooters in general. For example, if you've come from playing a MOBA such as League of Legends, you may be used to playing with a high DPI and sensitivity. MOBA players want a high sensitivity because it helps keep the actions per minute, or APM, high. But it isn't the same in shooters like Fortnite. You see, in shooters, you want your mouse movements smooth and under control, so you're able to aim accurately. Let's look at Counter-Strike Global Offensive, CSGO, for a moment. CSGO is a first-person shooter and one of the most popular and well-known shooter games of all time. In CSGO, all the best players use a low sensitivity, because a low sensitivity lets them aim better. Below you'll see a chart showing the sensitivity of CSGO players in relation to their rank. As you can see, the higher the ranks get, the lower the sensitivity gets. In other words, lower rank or bad players use a sensitivity that's too high. Now, I'm not saying simply lowering your sensitivity is going to make you global elite overnight, of course not. But it does give you a better chance to compete with other players when you're using sensible settings that allow you to aim properly. That being said, you don't want to use the same sensitivity of the best CSGO players in Fortnite, because Fortnite is an entirely different game. Fortnite is a third-person shooter and battle royale. In fact, you want your sensitivity to be high enough so you have the mobility to move around when you get shot from behind, and to build well, and so on. Mistake number 7, having an unorganized inventory. Your Fortnite inventory is where all your items are stored, and not taking time to organize your inventory into a logical order is a big mistake, because when you don't know what order your items are in, you have a high chance of switching to the wrong item, or you won't be as quick and confident when switching between items. This can get you killed. Listen, you want to be able to switch to each item in your inventory quickly, without even thinking about it, and the best way to develop muscle memory is by keeping your items in the same order in every game. So if you like your shotgun in slot 1, then it should always be in slot 1. And if you like your assault rifle in slot 2, then it should always be in slot 2. And so on for slots 3, 4, and 5. Mistake number 8, not taking advantage of sound. Sound is important in Fortnite, and I don't just mean to listen to music in the lobby. I'm talking about the ability to hear where enemy footsteps are, as well as listening for nearby chests. Obviously, knowing where your enemy is based on the sounds they're making is a distinct advantage, but to be able to do this, you need to know the direction of the sound. You're not going to get very good directional sound cues from your TV speakers either. This can only be accomplished with a good headset. Conclusion. Congratulations on making it to the end! I hope you've identified some mistakes that you are making, and now have a plan for how to correct it so you can become a better player as a result.